Joseph had to go from Nazareth to Bethlehem, so they had to go that way. How long would their journey probably have taken? So if you're going from Nazareth to Bethlehem, how long do you think it would have taken? Bearing in mind that it's 70 miles. And Mary was pregnant as well. And I know we see pictures of them, of Mary riding a donkey, but that's not actually in the Bible, but you know. So how do you think, how many people think it would be 4 to 5 days? Who thinks it would be 7 to 8 days? 14 to 15 days? Obviously it depends how fast they were going, but I read somewhere that an average of sort of 20 miles a day, which would be quite a lot actually, I think, especially for someone who's pregnant, but the consensus is it would have taken about 4 to 5 days. But that's open for discussion. That's not in the Bible, we're just trying to work that out. Okay, how many people were thought to live in Bethlehem at that time? So who thinks 1,000 people? Who thinks 2,000? 3,000? They say around 2,000. Again, we don't know for sure, but we think it's about 2,000. Okay. According to the Bible, why did the wise men make their visit Jesus? So were they inquisitive? Had they seen a star? Or they wanted to worship him? So, who thinks they were inquisitive? Who thinks they had seen a star? Who thinks they wanted to worship him? Well, you could argue that all three are correct, but actually, it does say that they, in the sequence, they wanted to worship him. So, I put that, but I could argue that all of those are correct. Where did the wise men of the Magi probably come from? Who thinks Jerusalem? Who thinks Persia? Who thinks Syria? Again, it doesn't actually say, but they say from the east, so it's more than likely that they came from Persia. Right. Definitely not Jerusalem. So Syria's in the north, so it wouldn't be Syria necessarily, although you could argue, well, parts of Syria to the east as well, but it's probably Persia. And how long would their journey of probably a few hundred miles have taken? Given that they were crossing deserts, it's likely that they travelled on camels, but there's no mention of this in the Bible either. So would it have been 3 or 4 months, or 5 months, or 5 to 6 months? Okay, 3 or 4 months. 4 to 5 months? 5 to 6 months. Again, this is only what I've read, so you know, it's probably a 4 to 5 months. So when Jesus was 8 days old, Mary and Joseph took him to the temple in Jerusalem for him to be consecrated. And so how far was Jerusalem, or is Jerusalem, from Bethlehem? Is it 1 to 2 miles, 3 to 4 miles, or 5 to 6 miles? Who thinks it's 1 to 2? 3 to 4? 5 to 6? It is actually 5 to 6 miles. Why did Mary, Joseph and Jesus go to Egypt rather than go home after his birth? Did they have to avoid King Herod? They wanted to visit family there, or they wanted to travel a little? So, two things they had to avoid: King Herod. Wanted to visit family there, they wanted to travel a little. Yeah, they had to avoid King Herod. Right, this is a difficult one. So, what is the closest distance between Egypt and Bethlehem? I was just trying to give you a picture of how much they had to travel, you know, at this time. So, what's the closest distance between Egypt and Bethlehem? Who thinks it's 40 miles? 30 miles? 20 miles? Again, it depends where you're going, but this is the closest bit of Egypt to Bethlehem at the time, and it was about 40 miles. When Herod died, an angel told the Holy Family to return to their home in Israel. So again, this is difficult because it depends where they were in Egypt. How far is it approximately from Egypt to Nazareth? So who thinks it's 260 to 270 miles? 360 to 370? 460, 470? Again, don't hold me to this, but I tried to work it out, and it's about 260 to 270 miles. Okay. And there's just a picture of a bit of the map. So there's Nazareth up there. Here's Bethlehem, there's Jerusalem. And by the way, when they travelled from Nazareth to Bethlehem, I know we said it was 70 miles, but Samaria's here, and they didn't get on with the people in the Samaritan, so they might have done a bit of a detour, so it might have been about 80 miles rather than 70 miles. And then you've got, down here you've got Egypt, so Bethlehem to Egypt, and then from Egypt all the way back up to Nazareth. That just gives you an idea, you know. So it was very difficult actually to pinpoint exactly the distances, but that gives you an idea.
Okay, thank you, Mary. And Dave is now going to bring us the second reading. Thank you.
Our second reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Amen.
Thank you, David. Let's sing again, and let's stand to sing our second carol, "Why Shepherds Watch."
Chocolates, mince pies galore, Christmas cake too, not to mention the turkey and trimmings, yet to get through. All preparation.
For each scene, he noticed two sets of footprints in the sand. One belonging to him, and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of his life flashed before him, he looked back at the footprints in the sand. He noticed that many times along the path of his life, there was only one set of footprints. He also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in his life. This really bothered him, and he questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I've noticed that during the most troublesome times in my life, there is only one set of footprints. I don't understand why, when I needed you most, you would leave me. The Lord replied, "My son, my precious child, I love you and I would never leave you. During your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you."
We're going to sing now, perhaps it's a new song for some of you, but if you do know it, please join in. If you'd like to just stay seated. And just perhaps reflect on what you've heard. Please join in if you want to.